Today, Houston SPCA investigators are in Waller County, Texas, preparing for a large-scale and potentially difficult seizure. Chief Investigator Max Mixon, Assistant Chief Investigator Charles Jansen, and Investigator Barbara Christiansen face a major challenge.
I was contacted by Waller County Sheriff's Department yesterday concerning the owner of these animals who is currently in jail. There is no one here to care for the animals. There are several animals with serious health concerns, so we decided that it was a good idea to go ahead and get a warrant and bring the animals in. Currently on the property, there is a llama, a mare with a newborn foal, about 15 to 20 chickens, 4 ducks, a goose, 5 dogs. The foal, I suspect, was born around 12:30, 1 o'clock yesterday. When we got here, she had just been born. The placenta was still on the ground and very fresh. She hadn't started walking yet. We're concerned because it doesn't look like the mare's producing as much milk as the baby needs. The baby's a little weak, and the mare is a little underweight as well.
Next, they turn their attention to the llama.
What we're trying to do is basically make a small little temporary paddock or pen to get the animal corralled up in, and then we can go ahead and shoe him directly onto the trailer.
The llama's winning right now.
I think that we need to lay off of him for a minute.
Let's start putting crates together, get some of the chickens and stuff boxed up, let him calm down and try again.
Some of the chickens have injuries from pecking each other.
Yeah, he's been beat up pretty good at the side of his face there. Yeah, let's get that puppy crated.
It's a struggle, but the team is pleased with the progress.
They're just making a lot of noise, vocalizing how much they don't appreciate being put into a crate, but they're not being harmed in any way. There you go, man. It's not bad.
Kitty, 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 kitty.
Most of the animals are quickly rounded up. But they still haven't managed to catch the llama.
One of the neighbors just stopped by. She's a little more familiar with the llama than we are. And there's a chance that she may be able to approach the llama a little better. The area is so big and we're so spread out that we're having a very difficult time getting them to stand still. It just doesn't make any sense to try to chase them around this whole property. So we need to kind of try to work a little smarter.
Max, basically all of us make a line and just move it over.
Yeah.
Like you do for cattle.
Watch that low spot, Alice. Watch your low spot.
Hold it up. No, don't let it down.
No, not there. The animals cooperated for the most part. The llama was a little bit difficult to get close to, but in the end, went right up on the trailer. The animals I've seen have been underweight. Some of the chickens have some fighting scars just amongst each other, so we need to get these guys back in and have them checked out by the vets. But most urgent matter at this point is the mare and the foal. Really underweight, she's not going to produce much milk, and we need to get her back and get that baby some supplemental feedings.
Back at base, Director of Shelter and Field Services Jim Baller and Dr. Ann Underwood are waiting to evaluate the 16 animals seized from Waller County.
Here.
Let's take all the ducks, chickens, and the two pigs, and we'll just set them up and put them in wildlife. That way it'll keep them separate.
Isn't that exciting? Hey, Yama.
Dr. Underwood examines the llama.
This is a normal coat for a llama. His is kind of matted, but as hot as it gets here in the summer, we're going to have to shear him because otherwise he'll just get way too hot and probably die of heat stroke. But we're going to wait and do that when we anesthetize him to castrate him. We'll just do it all at once. He's obviously not the most tolerant of creatures. Open up. Oh, swallow it. Yummy.
A foal and her mother, seized from the same property, are causing the most concern.
The mare is very thin. She's grading out basically close to emaciation. She's not a very old mare, but due to the nutrition depletion that obviously that she's suffering from, she's not producing a lot of milk, which in this case, the fact that she has a very young foal on her that's, you know, only a day or so old is not a good thing, because the first couple hours, the foal has to get what's known as colostrum, which is the mother's antibodies.
That's okay.
Pulling some blood on the baby to see what the passive transfer was in this case for the baby, if she got enough of it. If not, then we're gonna try and supplement it a little bit. The problem is that after the first 48 hours or so, the foal will not absorb the antibodies, the artificial antibodies that we're gonna have to give it. At this point now, we're just, you know, gonna kind of wait and see what happens, try and boost the mare up and get some supplements into the baby.
It's okay.
Okay,
it's
okay, Mama.
This mare appears to be a very good mother. She is trying to take care of her baby and is very protective about it. So that's a very good sign.
It's a critical time for the foal. But as for the other animals, they're recovering well. A week has passed since Houston SPCA investigator Barbara Christiansen seized 16 animals from Waller County. Today, she's in court to try to win custody of them. The owner is already facing animal cruelty charges and has been released from jail to give her side of the story. The case is being heard by Judge Charles Karish.
All of the animals that were brought into the shelter, except for two geese, were markedly underweight. One of the pigs also had a basketball-sized tumor on his right hip. It's so big and so severe and heavy that it's actually causing lameness in that right hind leg.
Goodness.
The mare that had delivered the foal on the first day that we went out to the property was very underweight as well. The llama, his main concern is, since the temperatures are rising, he should have been shorn by now. He's also a little underweight, and he had intestinal parasites as well.
I don't want to lose my animals. And I'm hoping that once I can get out, I'll be able to continue to take care of them.
The court, after hearing the testimony and examining the evidence, is of the opinion that the animals should be awarded to the Houston SPCA. And that is the court's decision.
I don't personally feel that this was in any way an intentional act of animal cruelty on the owner's behalf. I think it was just becoming overwhelmed, and we did need to step in this particular situation. This is just a great day for all the animals involved in this case, because this is where their new life begins, and we're going to be able to get them some good homes.
As for the mare and foal, they've made a complete recovery and have found a new home. They've been adopted by Kelly and Hector Avizo and their children, Joshua and Brianna.
I really don't know what they came from. I can only assume that it was very harsh. And, you know, giving them something that's more comfortable for them, it just makes me feel good.
Yeah, we were gonna think about getting a horse at the end of the summer, and this opportunity came about, and been smiling ever since, so.
So it's up and then down. Well, for the children, it's giving them a little bit more responsibility.
It's okay. I learned how to get Dash to come to me by myself, because Dash was a very, very shy of people whenever we first brought him here, and well, now he's coming to me.
They do a lot of the work to care for them, and then as a reward, they get to play with them at the moment, and eventually they'll be, you know, able to ride, and I think that's a real treat.
Once he starts eating, he just never quits.
They're part of the
family.
Yeah,
actually, yeah, they are. It's like, these horses are going to be here for quite a while.